So let's start out and have fun with some exponents, mostly the product rule and the quotient rule. These are kind of the fundamental things that you need to know whenever you're doing exponents. So first of all, before you get freaked out, product, that means multiply. Multiply. Come on, girl. There we go. Multiply, and quotient means divide. So a quotient means a division thing, okay? So a lot of times we'll start off and you'll be given a whole list of properties that you need to memorize, but rather than memorizing them, let's learn them so we don't have to actually memorize them. So a lot of times we'll start off give you something like this. Instead of using A, I'll use B. They'll say like B to the M times B to the N is equal to B to the M plus N. There we go, like that. And then they'll say, you should memorize this because it is true. Therefore, you should memorize it. And you're like, oh, okay, I'll do what you say and then I'll forget it later. So let's talk about what this actually means. So the idea would be like to say if I had something like, say I had 4 squared times 4, okay? So 4 squared times 4. Now, hopefully you remember that 4 squared just means 4 times 4. So that would be this guy. 4 squared means 4 times 4. And then the other times 4 is just still the same little times 4 dude. So you got like that. So now I have 1, 2, 3 4s. So that's 4 to the third. Kind of makes sense? So the idea is that I could just write them all out like this. 4 times 4 times 4 and get 4 cubed. Or I could potentially remember that this 4 has a 1 on it. And then go, oh, check it out. I've got a 2 and a 1. And we could say that 4 cubed is the same thing as 4 to the 2 plus 1. And those 2 plus 1s come from the 2 there and the 1 there. Kind of? Sort of? All right, let's do another one. See if that helps. Maybe something without a secret hidden exponent. Let's say I had 5 cubed times 5 to the 7th. That's nice and obnoxious. All right, so if we're using this property above that we really don't need to memorize, if we just kind of understand how it works, the idea is you could just say, well, I'm going to have, first of all, I'm going to have 3 fives, 5 times 5 times 5, just like that. And then I'm going to have 7 more fives. All right, so I've got 7 more fives. So I'm going to have 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I've got these 7 over here. So if I'm going to count them all up, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that means it's the same thing as multiplying 5 by itself 10 times. Now I could have done this now the fast way. 5 cubed times 5 to the 7th is equal to 5 times, or 5 to the 3 plus 7, and that equals 5 to the 10th. Kind of makes sense? So really, it's not a super secret formula, and I always feel like this is what I did whenever I would learn this stuff. I felt like there was some kind of like magic going on. They're like, memorize this because I said so, and you're like, what? But if you actually learn kind of the fundamentals behind where the stupid equation comes from, then it turns out you don't actually need to memorize a stupid equation because you just know the material. It's like you don't actually memorize how to spell your name, just at some point you know how to spell your name. Kind of one of those things. This is kind of what we're going for is spelling. Now what can make this more scary, I guess, is if we put x's in there. Like we could say x cubed times x to the 7th. And you're like, oh my god, it's x's. We're all going to die. And you're like, no, seriously, we're not going to die. So we can say, all right, well, I'm going to have 3 x's. X, x, x. And then I'm going to have, let's be consistent, 7 more x's. So I've got x, 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 just like that. So now I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 x's, just like last time. So I still have x to the 10th. All right. Or I could do it using the formula, which eventually you're going to want to just because it's less effort than writing out all these dumb x's. X cubed plus x to the, or times x to the 7th would be x to the 3 plus 7. Or just x to the 10. All right? So you can kind of get it both ways. Now, something really important. All right. So I kind of accidentally said this, and we might as well talk about it. This, we're done. There's nothing we can do to this. This is not equal to anything else. All right. The only thing that it's equal to is exactly that thing because it's connected with a plus sign. The only reason we're able to simplify this guy up here is because it's sitting there with a multiplication symbol. So if it's a plus sign, if you're just adding two polynomials together, we'll talk about that, I guess, another time. But if you're just adding two terms together, we're not going to combine the exponents. The only time we're going to combine the exponents is if we actually have multiplying, if we're actually multiplying the main thingies that we're dealing with. So that's good. Okay, so similarly, we also have the quotient rule. Now, again, the quotient rule would be if I have b to the m over b to the n, and b is not equal to 0, then I'm going to say that that is equal to b to the m minus n, which is all kinds of fancy. And again, a couple of things here. Don't get freaked out by this b is not equal to 0 thing. It just means you can't divide by 0, and this is kind of a thing that we've been doing for a while. I can't go 5 divided by 0 equals sad, okay? So I can't divide by 0. That's just the only reason that b is not equal to 0 there thingy is there. But let me show you where that comes from. So let's say we have 5 cubed divided by 5 squared. Now, if you're super, super good at math, one way you could do it is you could go 125 divided by 25 is equal to 5. And you're like, yay, good for you. But let's pretend we don't have our powers of 5 memorized. We could also say that we've got 3 fives on the top and 2 fives on the bottom. Now, remember that if I have something like 5 plus 2 divided by 5, remember I can't cancel out the fives like this. No! I just have to leave that the way it is. But if I have 5 times 2 divided by 5, I can cancel those fives out because it's a multiplication. So as long as I'm doing multiplication on the top and the bottom, I can do those cancel out thingies, the crossy out things. So just remember, we can do this because it's multiplication, but just kind of like with this other yikes, if it's addition, all bets are off. So just because we're in this special, beautiful world of multiplication. So basically, this 5 cancels out with this 5, and this 5 cancels out with this 5, and we just end up with 5 by itself. Okay? Or we can use the super fancy formula, which is going to say that 5 cubed minus 5 squared is going to be 5 to the, and I'm going to take that 3 and subtract the 2. So 5 times 3 minus 2, that's 5 to the first power, which is just 5. Got it? All right, let's do another one. So let's say I've got, I'll kind of leave that there for a template. So let's say I have something like, I don't know, 2 to the, I was about to say 42, but I want to type out 2 of those, 42 of those. Let's say 2 to the ninth divided by 2 cubed. All right. And I don't have 2 to the 9th memorized, or maybe I do, but I'm not super confident. So I'm just going to write this 2 out 9 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then on the bottom, I have 1, 2, and 3. And again, because these are being multiplied by each other and not added to each other, I can go ahead and I can say, well, these 2 cancel each other out, these 2s cancel each other out, and these 2 cancel each other out. So all I'm left with are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 2s on the top. So I'm ended up with 2 to the 6th power. Or I can apply the, so basically you're doing the subtraction, you're just taking an extra step, and you don't get bonus points for doing work in your head, so you might as well do it on paper so you actually know what's going on. So again, the other way that we would do this using our fancy formula or just kind of logicking our way through it is I'm going to take the number of 2s on the top and subtract off the number of 2s on the bottom. So I have 2, that looks funny, 2, 9 minus 3, and that's just going to give us straight up the 2 to the 6th. So if you're in a situation where you're trying to take a test, you're like, I can't remember what the stupid formula is. Just write it out and cancel out things. And honestly, no one's ever going to know because half the time you're doing this on a computer anyway. They don't really care how you get the right answer as long as you don't cheat or whatever. But, you know, it's pretty cool that you don't really have to memorize it as long as you kind of understand what's going on. Which is a big F, I understand. That's kind of intimidating as well. Now let's put X's in there because X's are scary. I'm going to do X's with the same numbers. So again, I'm going to put 9 X's on top. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, woo! And divided by 1, 2, 3 of them. So these x's cancel, these x's cancel, and these x's cancel. And I'm still up with the same 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 x's on the top. X to the sixth. So another way I could do it is again to say 9 minus 3, x to the 9 minus 3. And that gives me x to the sixth. Now, just to make sure you kind of know what's going on, here are some practice problems. So I recommend writing these down, pause the video, and then try and work through them. If you just watch me work through them, then you're not really going to know if you know it or if I know it. I kind of know that I know it. I mean, I know it well enough to make this video, but that doesn't really help you. So you want to make sure that you pause the video, work on these problems, and then if you get stuck, come back, or if you think you got it, come back. Even if you get stuck on a couple of them, go through those in the video, then pause it and try to work the rest of them without help, okay? So this last one I'm calling just for funsies because we're just making sure that you remember some things on how to do that. So get an actual number for that one. So get an actual number for funsies one. But for the rest of them, just simplify them the best that you can. So pause the video, and I know that you're like, no, I'm not going to pause it, but let's just like last chance effort now. Pause the video and try and work these out and see if that helps. All right? All right, so let's assume you've done that. All right, now I'm going to use the rules that we're supposed to be learning. But again, if it takes you a little bit of extra steps to get there, that's totally okay. So for here, we're multiplying these together. So I have 6 plus 4. So we're adding the exponents. So that should have given you 3 to the 10. And again, you could have written down 6 threes and then 4 threes and been like, oh, I have 6 and 4 threes. So I must have 10 threes. All right. This one is a subtraction because it's the quotient rule. So 7 fifths, 7 to the 5 minus 2, also known as 7 to the cubed. And again, you could have done your 5 sevens here and your 2 sevens on the bottom and had 3 left. And that's a perfectly legitimate way to get there. Now, eventually, you do want to be able to kind of take the shortcuts just so that your homework isn't taking you 50 years to do, but it's a good start. What might have gotten you on this one is remembering, come here, girl, that there is a secret one there. And so this would be one of those things where even if you know the rule and you're trying to apply it and you get a little confused, it could have helped to just have written out, okay, so I have two x's and I have a third x, and you're like, oh yeah, I remember that now. There's a secret one there. All right. So again, it's not just that we have these kind of long ways of doing it because we don't want to learn or we don't want to memorize, but also they can help us whenever we're really not sure. We kind of like, I think there's something I'm missing here. So you can write it out and kind of figure out what's going on. Okay, so let's say I've got that now. But again, let's pretend that we remembered that. I don't really care if we pretend we remember that or not. Nobody's looking. So again, the idea is I would have come in here and I'd have had x to the 2 plus 1, and that would have been x cubed. So again, the tricky part here was remembering that there was a secret one. All right, now this one we didn't actually talk about. So if you kind of got stuck here, that's okay. This was just kind of like, oh, can you figure this out on your own? Because a lot of times tests will do that. Hopefully not too much, but sometimes I went to the professor who's like, we didn't get to cover chapter 7, so I'm putting chapter 7 on the final. All right, but we won't do that to you, I promise. So anyway, the idea is I have a 5 and a 2. And again, this is one of those things where if you get confused, you can start writing things out. And if you start combining terms, you're like, oh, okay, so I'm going to multiply the 5 and the 2 together, and then I have 7 x's left. So you could have done it that way. But again, I'm just going to kind of do it the way we're theoretically supposed to do it. So you're going to combine the 5 and the 2. So 5 times 2 is going to give me 10. And then I have x to the 4 plus 3. So that's 10x to the 7th, just like that. Okay. Now we're looking at x to the 9th over x squared. So that's a subtraction. X to the 9 minus 2 is x to the 7th. And again, if you don't get all these right, don't panic. That's the whole point of learning, is like making mistakes and stuff. So don't freak out. Just be like, oh, okay, so I need to do this again. And that's all right. All right, same kind of thing here. We have the 14 divided by the 7. And again, if you want to write this out, x, 2, 3, 4, 7, x, 2, 3, and be like, oh, okay, so those cancel, those cancel, those cancel, and this makes a 2, you can do that. Because the whole point is to get the right answer through correct logic, and that's totally valid logic. So don't let anyone steal your shine on that. Do people still say that? I don't think they do. Anyway, I've got the 14 over 7. The 14 over 7 gives me a 2. Make red because it's pretty. Is a 2, and then I have x to the 4 minus 3. So that's x to the first. And you can just write that as 2x. And that's what you're looking at there. Awesome. All right, now for funsies, the biggest point of this is I wanted to make sure to remind you that whenever you're doing multiplication, when you're raising powers, when you have negative numbers raised to powers, that those negative numbers are included in the powers. So this is, again, one of those things when you're like, I don't know what to do. Start writing it out and see if it makes sense. So I've got 2 times 2, and this is honestly how I do this. 2 times 2, or sorry, negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4. Negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4. So now I have positive 4 times positive 4 times a negative 2. All right. So I've got a positive 4 times a positive 4 is 16. And then times a negative 2. So the answer is going to be negative 32. So some people like to make a rule where if the power is odd, the answer is going to be negative. And if the power is even, then the answer is going to be positive. So you might have seen that before. I forget things like that. They just don't stick in my head very well. But if they stick in your head for you, great. But generally, if you just work it out, you'll see exactly how this works. So some people will just kind of look at it and go 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 is 32. And the thing is odd, so it's negative. And if that works for you, great. If you don't quite like the way I did this, you know, you can, there's a couple of ways you could write it that might make more sense. Oops, that's supposed to be a 2. And you can just keep going left to right. So negative 2 times negative 2 is 4. And then you can just keep writing these. This is a lot of work, but you can do it that way. Negative 8. And then negative 8 times negative 2 is positive 16. And then negative 32. So whatever way makes sense for your brain, do it that way. And honestly, as long as you get the right answer, you know how you got it, and you can probably do it again later if someone asks you to, then you're in totally good shape.